Hello and welcome to this review of the Insta360 Go3S. I have the original Insta360 Go3 and I'm going to be talking about the differences between the two and why I went for this and what made me go for this. So initially when the Insta360 Go S3 came out, I thought I'm not going to get it. I thought it's a lot of money to spend when I've already got the Go3. However, you can get a single camera unit. So I bought the single camera unit and it's about £150 or $150 cheaper to get the single camera unit. Now that means that you don't get the action pod, but you can use the Go3S with the Go3's action pod. I don't think the action pod has changed. So you can take this out. The Go3S will also work with all the Go3's accessories. So why did I decide to get the Go3S when I've already got the Go3? This records in 4K and I do quite a lot of stuff in 4K. So it's quite useful to record in 4K and be consistent across all my cameras. Secondly, it has something called interval recording. So you can mount this and what it will do, you set it in the action pod and then as soon as you mount it, it starts interval recording. You can set the time limit. So I might record 15 second clips every 1 minute. And that means when I'm going out and doing something, I can just mount this on my chest or in my hat or wherever and not worry about it. It will record clips. I don't have to keep pressing it, which can be a bit annoying and no doubt you'll miss something when you're in the middle of action. So that was really useful. That was the main reason I got it, for the 4K and the interval recording. It does have some other bonuses. It does slow motion a lot better. You can now record 100 frames per second in 2.7K, which is an improvement over the Go3. And also something that I found quite useful is the way you orientate it determines how it records. So if you orientate it in this orientation, it records in portrait. If you orientate it like this, it records in landscape. The Go cameras have always been to me quick, easy ways to record things and to get footage really easily. So even just knowing that I'm going to record landscape when I put it like this is useful, because on the Go3 and the other Go cameras, I've stuck it on me like this or like that, and the format has come out wrong. It's recording the wrong format and I don't always record in free frame. So I don't actually like recording in free frame because it means you've got another step to make. So knowing that if I mount it like that, it's going to record in the right orientation is actually really useful. So the interval recording, the 4K, the mounting, the getting the correct orientation are all things that are quite important to me. So I paid £230 for this as the standalone unit for the 128 gigabyte version. So I went out and I recorded this footage. You can see here I am buying some fruit and you can see here I'm in a supermarket. I think the footage is really good. There's also an anti-jitter feature. So in the second recording in the supermarket, I put the anti-jitter feature on. I just think this is a really good camera. So far, I've been really pleased with it. And for me, I think it was a good upgrade from the Insta360 Go3. Thank you. Goodbye.